Hello, YouTube community. It's Robert S., and welcome back to Robscure Music, where I hope to introduce you or reacquaint you with lesser-known artists and/or albums that are out there in the musical universe. So today I'd like to speak to you about an American singer, songwriter, and actor, Bert Sommer. B-E-R-T-S-O-M-M-E-R. And he was born in February 1949 in Queens, New York, which is a suburb of New York City, or borough, I should say, of New York City. And growing up in the mid-60s as a teen, he became friendly with some of the other young musicians in the area, including Leslie West of the group The Vagrants. And they had a 1965 single called Oh, Those Eyes. Modest single, I'm not sure if you'll have heard of it. He also befriended Michael Brown of The Left Bank. And The Left Bank, you may recognize as having a hit in 1966 with the song Walk Away, Renee. They also had a hit in 67 with a song called Pretty Ballerina. Anyway, in 1967, Bert actually joined the Left Bank, which is actually an interesting sort of side story. The Left Bank was formed, and Michael Brown's dad, Harry Lukowski, I think his name was, he was a session violinist, but he also owned a recording studio. And so he let the Left Bank record in his studio, and you know, he heard it, and he basically recognized the potential that they had, and he soon became their manager, their producer, and their publisher. And of course they had the hits Walk Away, Renee, and Pretty Ballerina. But this, you know, not too long afterwards, or during that time, I should say, tensions arose between Michael and his dad and the other band members. So what Michael's dad decided to do was create his own version of the Left Bank and not have to deal with these other band members. So he brought on Bert Sommer as the lead singer. He also brought on a guitarist named Michael McKean. And Michael, much like Bert, is a musician and an actor. And you may not recognize that name, Michael McKean, but you'll know some of the roles that he had, perhaps. He played Lenny in the 70s show Laverne and Shirley. He was in This Is Spinal Tap. And more recently, he played Chuck McGill, the lawyer who was the brother of the main character in the Breaking Bad spinoff called Better Call Saul. Anyway, so Michael Brown's dad creates this new version. And of course, the old version, the old members are not happy with that, and they bring in their lawyers, and there's a whole legal dispute, and things kind of fall apart. So it ends with the Left Bank, but fortunately for Bert, his work in the Left Bank gets recognized, and he gets a record deal with Capitol Records. And he also gets an invitation to join the Tribe, I think it was called, in the LA production of the musical Hair. And he does well. He actually gets promoted to the role of Woof, and his sort of frizzy Afro hair and his eyes actually are put on the LA playbill for the musical Hair, and I'll show you that. So then in 1969, he releases his first album called The Road to Travel. And that record is produced by Artie Cornfeld. And for those of you who don't know who Artie Cornfeld is, not only is he a record producer, he's one of the most famous music promoters. He promoted something that was called 3 Days of Music and Peace, a music festival that occurred on Max Yasgur's dairy farm in upstate New York. Of course, that festival is Woodstock. So, having a connection to Artie, Bert actually gets invited to perform at Woodstock. Now, keep in mind, he's just released his first album. He's a solo artist, and his first live performance is at Woodstock. So he actually is the third act to perform on opening day, August 15th, 1969. And of course, Richie Havens opens up the festival with an incredible performance, fantastic set. He's followed by Sweetwater. And Sweetwater actually was a band that was supposed to be the opening act, but they got stuck in traffic, much like many other artists and people coming in from into that area in Woodstock experienced. There was heavy, heavy traffic. So they actually came in by helicopter, but not in time to perform first. So they follow Richie Havens. And unfortunately for them, their band was, you know, they had, I think, six or seven people in the band. They had cello, a flute, you know, their instrumentation was much more complex than Richie Havens was. And they had some sound issues. Their instruments were actually being mic'd through the vocal mics. And, you know, the sound quality wasn't quite there. I think it was well received overall, their performance, but later on they would joke that they were the sound check for Woodstock, basically. Anyway, so Bert comes out after that and he does 10 songs and he is very well received by the band. He does a song, an original called Jennifer, which is a song that was inspired by his Hair fellow cast member, Jennifer Warnes. And Jennifer Warnes might be a name that you know, not necessarily from her singles, but from her very, very well-received number one hits that were duets with, and there are two of them that really made her famous. The first one was a song that she did with Joe Cocker, who was called Up Where We Belong, from the movie An Officer and a Gentleman. Her other duet was with Bill Medley of the Righteous Brothers, and that was from the movie Dirty Dancing. It was called I've Had the Time of My Life. Anyway, getting back to Bert, so he does the song Jennifer. He did a song called Smile, another original, which I think is just a fantastic upbeat song, and that would actually appear on his next album. It wasn't on the first album. And he did a cover of the Simon and Garfunkel song America. His performance is so well received that he gets the first standing ovation at Woodstock. And of course, he jokes that people were standing to get up and go to the bathroom, but hey, they stood, so it's a standing ovation. Anyway, so then unfortunately, you know, he kind of walks away from Woodstock thinking, you know, wow, this was great, you know, things went well. Unfortunately, the rights to Woodstock get sold to Warner Brothers. And when Woodstock comes out in March 1970, he's not on it. And the reason he was given is basically he's with a rival record company, Capitol. And, you know, that could have meant instant stardom for him, being associated with the Woodstock Festival. But unfortunately, he kind of becomes the forgotten artist of Woodstock, and he has to sit back and watch other first-timers like Richie Haven, Melanie Santana and 10 years after reaped the benefits of having been at Woodstock. So he's not on the initial Woodstock soundtrack, but in 2009, three of his songs would become public for the first time. But at that point, you know, too little too late, decades too late, actually. And in 2019, his whole 10-song set appears on the 50th anniversary, I think it was 38 CD set that comes out, if you want to hear it. But anyway, so later on in the year, in 1970, he releases his second album, and this is called Inside Bert Sommer. Unfortunately, I don't have his first or his second albums, so I can't show those to you. But this second album actually contains a song called We're All Playing in the Same Band, which was a modest hit for him. I think it didn't break the top 40, but I think it was somewhere in the like upper 40s. And he gets, you know, some, obviously some recognition and all, but again, that sort of that missed opportunity at Woodstock, I think really hurts him at that point. And then in 1971, he releases his third album, and that's this one called simply Bert Sommer. And, you know, this contains a lot of the same sort of mellow folk pop music. Honestly, a lot of his songs, some very much so, sound like Donovan. And, you know, I enjoy this album. I enjoy a lot of his music, as I generally try to do in my videos. I will be playing some parts of many of his songs later on, so you can get to hear what he sounds like. But in any event, so by the time he releases this, you know, it's like I said, it's a missed opportunity. I think music moves away from that folk pop mellow sound. And in 1977, he tries to come back and he releases another album actually called Bert Sommer, but this is on a different record label. And again, a somewhat enjoyable album. I don't like it as much as I like his first three albums, but it, you know, it's got some decent songs on it. So that's it. So why don't we take a listen to some of his songs, and I'll see you on the other side.
Jennifer's heaven for Jenny, I'd stay. Skin shining white as a dove. Lying beside her, I melted away into the river of love. Warm, lost in a maze, counting the ways that she smiles. Time is slipping away, lost in the arms of a love so gentle and wild. Jennifer, something you handle with care, fragile as crystals of glass. Nights by the fire when she was there, now all I see is an empty chair. She's gone, and this man is dying. There was a time when I'd laugh and sing. All I have left is a dusty ring. She's gone. There's no purpose in trying. The door stays open in the day. The lock's still broken, and the way I feel without. Every day is like a week. I gotta find some kind of rules to follow. And my daddy wonders why, how I look can make him cry. But I'll carry on his name when he dies. As I lie upon the brink of death, knowing soon I'll take my final rest, I can see the golden isles in the clouds that reach for miles. Someone's calling me, come and warms up the outside. The morning is arrived. It's a beautiful day. Dreaming and seeing her eyes in the mist on the window that looks on the garden. A new one is starting. It's a beautiful day. Things are looking better, trying to forget her. I got myself together, the feeling's right. I was looking fine, I got it cooking. Things are looking better, the feeling's right. Just smile, smile, and the world smiles with you. Smile, all the love is in your together, just doing all we can. It would start to make it better. It only takes a song to understand. Why should you be angry? Why should you be sad? Don't be disappointed. And these are the people who followed you down. Break out the good love, pass it around. They're waiting to take you away for free, 'cause they're friends, all your friends. And your friends will always be the day you die. You've got your friends. We're all playing in the same band. Sing the song together and you'll see. Let them know forever just where you stand. People must be learning. Finally. baby, I'm lost. Oh, I said, though I knew she was sleeping. I'm empty, I'm aching, and I don't know why. Counting the cars on the New Jersey Turnpike, they've all come to look for America. All come to look for America. They've all come to look for America.
If we would only stick together, we'd start to look out for each other. I know it's all been said 1,000 times before, and I will be one more. Won't you join the line and give the world a good sign? It would be easy. And all the world over so easy to see. People everywhere just wanna be free. Ask me my opinion will be peace in the valley, people gotta be free. Peace in the valley, people gotta be free. And if there's a man who is down and needs a helping hand, all it takes is you to understand and to pull him through.
I've had my troubles, I came up the hard way. You can't imagine the things I have seen, and all of my trials and my tribulations. Lord, it ain't been nothing for someone like me. When there was a shortcut, but all the nights I cry for the love that died, where we lay. And it's a lonely feeling stuck inside the maze. Time is endless since I slept beside you. Maybe it's in your imagination, but all of your sweet dreams were not what they seemed. I couldn't take it as far as you want to go. When you feel it, you don't have to try.
The same as the sunshine. Whoa, me and the sunshine. Oh, me and the sunshine. Whoa, me and the sunshine. Happy forever, being together. Happy forever, being together. Happy forever, being together.
So that was Bert Sommer. Hope you enjoyed that. And, you know, this was, in my opinion, Woodstock's forgotten artist. And, you know, if you think about it, he was in two of the 1960s most famous counterculture events, Hair and Woodstock. And yet, very few know his name. He is a lesser known artist. So I wanted to bring an awareness of him and his music, and I hope you enjoyed it. So that's it, friends. Stay well, and remember, if the music strikes a chord, let it play.